This is Athens, Georgia, a calm little community that's about to get shaken up with a college football rumble. And now the coin toss, and it's presented by Nissan, innovation that excites. Arkansas State is getting fired up down there as they get ready to boot this opening kickoff. Jackson from the six. Tackle made at the 33. The Bulldogs offense basically predicated on what this kid can do.
Thing I love about this guy, Brad, is just the intangibles that he brings to the table. We've been seeing this guy make plays over the weeks, but the thing that I really recognize is his ability to really lead this football team. When things are going well, he's patting everybody on the back. When things are not going well, he's trying to pick them back up and getting them ready to go. So not only does he physically have the tools, but also I really love the way he approaches the game.
Tackle made around the 38-yard line. A huge run.
I'll tell you right now, this guy is arguably one of the fastest players in college football today. There you see him turn it upfield with such fluidity and quickness.
Quick throw out to the receiver, incomplete.
He must have hurried there because his receiver was wide open. There was no need to rush that one at all.
Second down, 10 to go. Ball on the 38-yard line. Down at about the 27-yard line. Superb effort by the receiver to come down with that ball.
Well, this comes down to the timing between the quarterback and the receiver, and the result, again, a nice play for the offense.
And he's taken down around the 24-yard line. And he gains around three on that keeper.
With the defensive line neutralizing the blocks, these linebackers are able to come up and make plays in the holes.
Third down now. They need to get it to the 17. Five wide. Quick strike to the receiver. Tackle around the 3-yard line. They'll spread the field here. Let's see what the defense does with a five wide outlook. Converts the extra point. So that's an 8-play, 68-yard drive, and they come away with 7 points.
Brad, I thought the offense did a really nice job of mixing up the play calling on that drive. I thought the defense was on its heels most of the drive because of the versatility of the offense.
So our score, 7-0. Merritt from the three. And down he goes at the 29. The quarterback brings his troops out of the field for the first drive of the game. And he's immediately tackled.
Yeah, the defense looked a little sluggish there, and they can do better than that.
He's tackled at the 44. And a nice catch there before he stepped out of bounds.
He had a couple of freight trains coming at him, but when they blitzed, it created a hole in the coverage. They took advantage of it.
So the referee initially calls it a catch, but we'll get a second look at it here and determine if he was in bounds when he hauled it in.
And that play happened so fast that it was very tough to tell if he was able to get a foot down or not.
Well, I know the receiver isn't too happy, but they got it right after the review. No catch. Third down, 8 yards to go. Ball on their own 44. screen pass. He's got his halfback. They'll bring him down at the 42-yard line.
Well, as you just saw right there, the screen pass can be a very effective weapon for an offense, especially when they're disciplined and when the receivers are patient.
He throws a dart to the left. Oh, boy, almost intercepted.
That could have been a huge shift in momentum if they were able to hold on to that one. Wow, that was close.
From the 42-yard line, second down. At the corner. And down he goes at the 27.
This is smart, efficient play calling. You don't need to make the highlight reel on each play.
And he can't get away from the pressure. Just an excellent individual effort to make the play there.
I have to tell you, for being so young, he looks pretty good out there at linebacker.
We've got third and 10. Ball on the 27-yard line. Zips it right. Fires quickly. Touchdown! We'll be tied with the extra point. He splits the uprights with the extra point. It was an 8-play, 70-yard drive, and the result, 7 points. We're even at 7 in this one. Grace, ready to kick. Jackson, from the 9. And he's tackled at the 33-yard line. So it's time to see this offense go to work again.
This defense couldn't stop them from moving the ball and inevitably finding the end zone. Green
eight. And he's level at the 42.
It's got to be frustrating for this offense to go backwards, but they've just got to stick with it and know that big plays will eventually happen.
Third down, and they're going to need about 3 yards to pick up the first down. Caught, open field. He's knocked out of bounds at the 39. For his man, incomplete. From the 39-yard line, second down. And he makes it out to about the 37-yard line. Cavalry's coming. He heaves it to the end zone. It's caught. Touchdown, Georgia. Kirk, that was a beautiful pass and a nice catch.
Well, this is one of those plays you just sit back and admire. The quarterback threw the ball perfectly. And again, the speed of the receiver is the difference in this play.
Tacks on the extra point. A 6-play, 68-yard drive, and they put up 7 points.
Brad, I thought that was a textbook drive. I thought they did a really good job of showing balance, mixing the play calling with the run and the pass. Just an overall well-executed touchdown drive.
So the score now, 14-7. Fielded at the 4. At the 30. He's taken down at the 37.
This is my kind of game. We're getting a chance to see so many touchdowns. I just wonder if this offense could continue the flow that we've seen from the previous three series.
The offense really came up with a nice drive there last time out, and most of those yards came through the air.
This defense needs to improve from front to back. The line needs to put more pressure on the quarterback, and the defensive backs need to stick it to these receivers with tighter coverage.
On the ball, on the ball. Hustle back, hustle back. Check nine.
He's out of bounds at the 43. Plenty of time in the pocket. Quarterback's going to run it, and he's got room to work. It's scooped up. He's tackled
right around the 44-yard line.
First and 10. Ball on the 44. Goes quickly, and it's almost intercepted. Spread the field in the gun with five wide receivers. And they make the stop around the 35-yard line. They'll spread the field with five wide. Makes the grab and gets knocked out of bounds. Hit immediately.
We gotta move quick right here.
And they've got the dime package in there to try and deal with this five receiver look. Throws complete and he stopped immediately. Hit before he can go anywhere. Touchdown, Arkansas State. The extra point to tie this game up. And he adds the extra point. Looks like they're ready for the kick. He makes it out to maybe the 33-yard line. Kirk, I got to ask you, are the defenses ever going to show up on this one?
The crazy thing, Brad, is these guys have had all week to prepare to get ready to face these offenses, and so far, just no luck.
Six points and a pretty display of passing was a result of their last drive. Kirk, do you expect the defense to take a different approach here?
When this quarterback is on, he is on. It already seems like whatever this defense is trying just isn't working. But maybe if they add just a little bit more pressure, then they might be able to force him into a mistake.
Fires out to his receiver. Tackle made at about the 35. Out of bounds, around the 28-yard line.
Move on, baby.
receiver. Third down now, and they need to get it to the 25. They'll line up with five wide receivers. Brought down at the 22-yard line. Quarterback all by himself in the backfield with five wideouts. Fires incomplete.
This is a well-designed play by the offensive coordinator. Everything really seemed to be working just fine, except for the quarterback. He's got to throw a better football.
So it's second and 10. Ball on the 22-yard line. Here's the halfback on the screen. And he is drilled at the 15. Receiver, touchdown. And he hits the PAT. An 8-play, 66-yard drive. And they get it in for seven.
Brad, I love these kind of drives. They're old school. Grind it out and earn the yards and just rip the heart right out of that defense.
Georgia lines up for the kickoff. Green fields it at the three. They'll bring him down at the 32-yard line. And while they are behind, they know they can knot things up in a heartbeat. It's way too early to change your game plan. Gains his way to the 43-yard line.
On the ball, on the ball, on the ball, on the ball.
Receiver, and he can't make the grab.
Not a great throw by the quarterback, but to be fair, that was pretty good coverage.
From the 46-yard line, it's second down.
Let's go!
They go to the run, and he's tackled in the backfield for a loss. Scoreboard lit up in that first 15 minutes. The Bulldogs with a touchdown lead. And we welcome you back to the action here, just about set to start the second quarter. The punter is going to try to pin them deep in their own territory with a good punt here. Tackle made at the 26-yard line. With one quarter down, I really haven't seen too much separation between these two squads. Might be neck and neck the whole way. Georgia, up 7 points. He's to the 40. Gains his way to the 46-yard line. Looks middle, got his back. And he's taken down at the 48.
Ball, ball, ball.
Makes it to the 34.
He's at the 20.
Excellent open field tackle. Run, and he's brought down. Tackle around the 3-yard line. It's third down, and they're about 2 yards shy of the sticks. And out come the big hefties. Fires to his tight end, nothing doing.
Brad, I just think this quarterback's got to do a much better job of being able to read that defense and make quicker decisions. And especially when the defense starts to get pressure, you've got to either get rid of that football or check it down or take off and run with it.
And he's tackled at the one.
Everybody bunched up tight defensively. And he converts the extra point. A 9-play, 74-yard drive, and a touchdown as a result.
And it was really those long runs that really helped propel that drive.
Blankenship looks ready to kick this one off. Merritt fields it at the 2. And he's hammered down. It was a pretty one-sided first quarter, but I wouldn't be surprised if things changed in a big way before halftime. Good tackle there in space. Under heavy pressure. Moves up, and the defense has got him. Third and 5. Ball on 34. Empty backfield. Quarterback in the gun. 5 wide receivers. Zipped it out, and that was almost picked off. Grace is waiting for the snap. And he makes it out to about the 44-yard line. Georgia's offense is just clicking on all cylinders, Herbie, right now. It's everything they planned for, and it's all working.
Everything is coming together for this offense. They seem to be getting better with each series. And, you know, this game started where this team was, you know, they wondered if they were going to be able to move the ball against this defense. And I think right now, I think they seem to, as I said earlier, they seem to be growing with their confidence with each possession.
Makes it to the 44. And for Swift, he just broke 100 yards on the ground.
And the linemen are doing a great job of keeping the initial tacklers away and getting a good downfield push. I know that's helped him a lot today.
They'll bring him down around the 30-yard line. Swift gets it on the inside. He's tackled in the open field. He's at the 20. Makes it to the 11. On the ground, inside. He fights forward to about the 10. A 1-yard gain by the halfback.
Watch seven. Watch seven. Watch seven. Watch seven. Check, check.
quick to the receiver, and it falls incomplete. From the 10-yard line, it's third down. Flips it, middle to the running back. And down he goes at the 8. A couple of yards that time on the screen.
Nice grab there by the tailback to at least move the ball forward for some positive yards.
It's up, and it's through the uprights. The kicker looks like he's ready to kick this one off. Green from the 2. Tackle at the 23. It's still only the second quarter. We've got a lot of football left, but I've got to say, this one is teetering on the brink of a blowout. To his man on the screen. He's taken down at the 29-yard line. About 6 yards on the play.
You get 6 yards, and that makes picking up a first down very reasonable.
Just throws this one away. They're about 4 yards away here on third down. Fires out to his wide out. Good open field tackle. Murray gets a handoff to the right. Tries to get around the corner. He's pushed out of bounds at about the 41. Quick pass. He's tackled around the 47-yard line.
Not today. Got two. Double.
Gets it to his wide receiver, and he's got another one. Level at the 46. Gets it out quickly. And he's immediately tackled.
Well, the passing game is a lot easier for a quarterback when two corners aren't in coverage. I respect the gutsy call on the defensive side to blitz both corners, but it left him too vulnerable against the pass.
And this is the 9th play of the current drive. Caught, and he's hit immediately. Got it, complete, he's out of bounds. First down, and they've got their eyes on that goal line.
Ready, fire,
and he hits him hard at the 3-yard line. They pick up a good 6 yards there.
Good recovery here by the corner to react that quickly on the throw and prevent this from becoming even a bigger game.
Touchdown, Red Wolves. Tacks on the extra point. Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. I'll tell you what, if you don't like offense, turn this thing off. If you do, stick around. This one's fun.
Yeah, if you're a traditionalist, this is probably not the best game for you. This is college football in 2013. Up and down the field with these quarterbacks putting up huge numbers.
The quarterback leads his squad back out. They got three on their last possession. Sets up a screen. Tailback's got it. And they make the stop around the 9-yard line. Second down and 10 to go. Ball on the 9. The quarterback in the gun with 5 receivers. Quick throw. Robertson picks up about 5 yards on that hookup. Space. Hard at the 42. Quick out to his receiver. And that'll do it. We head to the break. Still plenty of time left in this one. The Bulldogs with a 10-point lead.
Glad to have you with us in the studio for the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Reese Davis and David Pollack here, completely locked in on that first half. Neither offense ran into anything that suggested any type of trouble for them in the first half, both running up and down the field pretty much at will. Did you get the sense, David, that the defenses were a little tentative, that they were a little shell-shocked by what had happened? And if so, what do they need to do to change that in the second half?
It's hard not to get that sense when the offense just goes shoot, 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 up and down the field and has success. But, you know, it's interesting. If you're going to continue to give up points and you know your offense is continuing to score, why not get aggressive on defense? I mean, don't sit back. Don't let them dink and dunk. Don't let them run the football. Bring some guys up in the box. Play some man coverage. If you're going to give up points and you know you're scoring at a high clip, go for the gusto, baby. Try to make some big plays.
That'll do it here in the studio at halftime. We'll try to see if Pollack can bring a little energy in the second half. Got a lot of games to watch, including yours. Brad and Kirk, ready for the second half.
All right, Reese and David, welcome back, everybody. Just about set to start the second half. He'll return it from the 1. Brought down at the 29.
That's where you fired the ball.
There's got to be some sense of urgency to this offense right now. They don't have the luxury of wasting drives if they want to get back in the game. He makes it out to maybe the 29-yard line. So he decides to hold on to it, and it goes nowhere. Quick release, tight end, incomplete. From their own 29-yard line, third down. Quarterback all by himself in the backfield with 5 wideouts. Nice catch there before he stepped out of bounds.
Let's go, let's go.
The offense going to try to open this field up, coming out in a 5-wide set. And the defense counters with their dime look. Throws complete. He's hammered.
Gets him open field. He's at the 30, to the 20. Tackle made at the 14. Push him out around the 13-yard line. Handoff up the middle. 7 yards there on that bit of misdirection. So with that run, they pick up another first.
It's a nice job again up front by the offensive line. They're doing a good job of neutralizing the defensive front, and it's allowed them to move the ball down the field.
They line up in the jumbo set. Touchdown, Arkansas State. Trying to get within a field goal. They'll try the point after. He splits the uprights with the extra point. Arkansas State to kick. From the 7. Knocked out of bounds. Right around the 28-yard line. The quarterback leads the offense back out onto the field as we get set to resume play. Georgia is up by 3. Gains his way to the 39-yard line. They come out in an empty backfield. And a quick throw. Brought down around the 50-yard line.
This receiving corps runs some great routes, and that last play was an example of that. As a defender, it can be tough to match up sometimes.
He's at the 40. Gains his way to the 40-yard line. The quarterback in the gun. Empty backfield. 5 wide receivers in the formation. And they get nice yardage on that run. Run to the outside. And he's taken down at the 28. From the 28-yard line, it's second down. Zips it to the back, and he's shoved out of bounds at the 31. And this is the 8th play of the drive. Georgia holds a field goal lead. Catches it and hit immediately for a loss. Drop back 4 yards on that one.
Well, that's just a sound play by the defense. They dropped him well short of the line of scrimmage.
They're trying to pin them deep with a solid punt right here. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. Georgia's coaches just got to be happy. I'd love to coach a kid like this.
Oh, I think these coaches love to coach a guy like this. And another great performance by him individually and for this offense.
This deficit can be easily overcome, sure. But they have to be thinking if they don't get something going on this series, the burden is going to be felt by their defense.
And he's tackled at the 36-yard line. Takes it right. He can't get back to the line.
That is exactly the type of play that good linebackers make on a regular basis. And if you can make enough of them in college, probably going to get a chance to play at the next level.
It's second down, 12 to go. Ball on their own 34. Screen pass. He's got his halfback. Tackle right around the 38-yard line. Defense lays him out. Grace to punt. He's to the 40. Tackle made at the 45-yard line. Arkansas State's not going to back down from anybody, Herbie. I guess at least not today.
No, not today. They've played with a chip on their shoulder. They've stood toe-to-toe with the big boys, and I don't think they're finished yet.
And here we go with the offense ready to get things going again. Georgia is up a field goal. Fires it out. They'll bring him down around the 38-yard line. Some room, and he carries the ball for a nice game. Slings it, and down he goes at the 30-yard line. His way to about the 22. Fires out to his receiver. He's taken down at the 20-yard line. Throw, and he's got his receiver again. He's tackled at about the 13. It's third down, and this offense is about 3 feet away from that first down marker. They'll spread the field with five wide. He gets hit out of bounds at the 2-yard line. Georgia has a 3-point lead. Makes a move, and he's in for the touchdown. And he hits the PAT. To kick this one away. From his own goal line. And down he goes at the 22. You know they'd like to do something a little more than they did on their last drive when they had to punt the ball away.
Down two possessions, this offense has to step up and capitalize on this possession.
And he's tackled right away. Five wide.
great tackle at the 44-yard line. He makes his way to about the 42. Here comes the pressure.
Throws it, and oh, he dropped it.
You never know what will happen when the ball ricochets like that. Good effort by the defender.
From the 42-yard line, second down. Strike to his receiver, no good. The stop at the 26. Good open field tackle. Has the INT. They need about 3 yards to get the first down here on third down. Fires complete over the middle. Huge play, and it's going to be first and goal. Hit immediately. And that'll bring this third quarter to a close. 38-28, Georgia. All right, we're just about set to start action here again in the fourth quarter. Down after a nice run up the middle. He tackles him for a loss.
That was just smash mouth, helmet to chin football by the defensive line there. They dominated the point of attack.
The offense is staying on the field. It's all or nothing. Here we go. They come out in a goal line set.
Here we go.
Touchdown, Red Wolves. Nice time to use the fullback there.
I've always liked when teams mix it up and give the fullback the ball in goal line situations. If the big bruiser can't get you a couple of yards, you don't deserve to get in.
And he adds the extra point. The kicker looks like he's ready to kick this one off. He's to the 20. Tackle at the 29-yard line. You know this is a real crucial time in the game. It could still go either way. Georgia is up by 3. Pocket holds. Halfback's got it on the quick throw. Makes it to the 45-yard line. Play,
didn't sack him, the pressure was still enough to force a bad pass. If you can get in there and disrupt the pocket, then the quarterback is going to have a tougher time getting the ball to his playmakers.
Third down, and they need to get it inside the 47. He goes out of bounds at the 46-yard line. Merritt is back deep to return. And he's taken down at the 23. The Bulldogs kept climbing and scratching their way back in this football game. You can never count anybody out, I guess.
Isn't it amazing to see what momentum can do in college football? This team right now has captured momentum. It's on their side. Now can they ride that wave to the end and try to win this game?
Quick throw, incomplete, Wano's receiver.
You know, sometimes the toughest throws to make for a quarterback is when he has a wide receiver wide open, and everybody in the stands is saying, throw it, and you aim the football instead of just getting back in rhythm, stepping, and throwing. And that time, he aimed the ball, and it was incomplete.
To the tailback. Tackle made around the 28-yard line. Grace is waiting for the snap. He gets out to about the 48-yard line. Both teams realize that when the ball is snapped, we're one play away from a very different ball game. Georgia holds a field goal lead. Makes it to the 34. Receiver. Brought down right around the 22-yard line. He's into the open field. Very good tackle in space. Receiver, touchdown. He's been on the receiving end of three touchdown passes.
Yeah, this guy is in a zone. He's catching every single ball thrown his way.
And he converts the extra point. They're ready for the kick. He's to the 20. Across the 30. He's pushed out of bounds at the 38. We've seen this guy make some big plays for his team tonight.
Well, his mobility in the pocket, I think, is what's causing this defense nightmares. And now with these two scores, I think he's really showing this defense the damage that he can do running the football. And I think it's just opening up that much more in this offense.
Well, his team is trailing, so he's going to have to keep up the high level of play. They couldn't get anything going on that last drive. Dumps it complete to the halfback over the middle, and they'll get him in the backfield. That's a loss of 4 yards.
This defense is fast enough that they can create negative yards on completed passes. So the offense might want to consider that next time they try that play.
So it's second and 14. Ball on the 34.
Here we go!
And he tackles him hard at the 35-yard line. He makes his way to about the 45. And it's the offense that takes the field on fourth down. Quick strike to the receiver. And he's taken down at the 37.
Let's go! Check, check! Eagle!
Throws complete. He's got space to work. And he hits him hard at the 31-yard line. Set up a little screen, gets it to his tailback, and he's tackled at about the 19-yard line.
Yes, sir. You don't want that. You don't want that. Get out of here, baby.
Less than 3 minutes in the game. Throws quick to the receiver, and it falls incomplete.
Brad, I just think this quarterback's got to do a much better job of being able to read that defense and make quicker decisions. And especially when the defense starts to get pressure, you've got to either get rid of that football or check it down or take off and run with it.
Tackle at about the 17-yard line. Tailback incomplete. It's fourth down. So the field goal unit is on the field. They'll try for 3 points. And they can make this a one possession game with this kick right here. Kicks up, and the field goal is good. Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. He makes it out to maybe the 29-yard line. And offense is back on the field after running the ball very well on their last drive.
This offensive line really opened up some big gaps for the running back last time.
And they get nice yardage on that run. Stop with that incompletion.
Boy, I don't understand that strategy at all. With the lead late in the game, you just need to run the football. That's not a smart decision.
So it's third down now, and they're going to need about four. Just under 2 minutes in the game. And he's level at the 44.
A quarterback's best friend is a receiver he can count on to catch the ball every time he drops back to pass.
Makes it out to about the 46.
You talk about a dual threat guy. This guy can hurt you in the air or on the ground.
They'll line up with five wide receivers. He makes his way to about the 32.
What is going on with his defense? I mean, don't get me wrong. The offense is doing a nice job with first downs and they're executing well, but the defense is just letting them maintain possession and move the ball right down the field. They've got to try to change things up with their scheme. Be more aggressive, attack, do some things to change it up, take some risks.
From the 19-yard line, it's first down. Run, and he's brought down. This is the eighth play of this drive. We should just see the quarterback take a knee right here, winding down the rest of this clock. Nothing more demoralizing for a defense than seeing the opposing quarterback take a knee. Georgia staff just dancing on the sideline. Their star player came through for them, and they couldn't be happy.
Well, the staff has to feel good. The entire team should feel good. And I know you and I just having a chance to sit back and watch this young man play. Just an outstanding performance and something that this entire team will be able to build on.
Thanks for joining us for another game of NCAA Football 14. For Kirk and everyone here at EA Sports, Brad Nussler saying goodbye, and we'll see you next time.